Hello, good morning, all of you. So today, class 9th, history lesson 2, part 3rd. I'm going to start the new lesson, Socialism in Europe and Russian Revolution. Hope you all like it. First of all, we discuss about the February Revolution in Petrograd. As we all know that during 1970, the condition of Petrograd, the capital of Russia at that time, was not so good. The workers' quarter, which you all know that it is on the right bank of the river Neva, and in the left bank of the river Neva, all the aristocrats' winter palace is situated. In February 1917, food shortage was deeply felt in the workers' quarter because of heavy snow, frost. So, on 22nd February, a lockdown took place at a factory on the right bank because one of the labor was dismissed from the factory. The next day, workers in 50 factories called a strike. As the fashionable quarters and official building were surrounded by workers, the government imposed a curfew and demonstrators disappeared by the evening, but they came back on 24th and 25th. The government called out the cavalry and police to keep watch on them. But on Sunday, 25th February, the government suspended the Duma and demonstrators returned in force to the street of the left bank on the 26th. On the 27th, the police headquarters was ransacked. The street thronged with people raising slogans about bread, wages, better hours, and democracy. The Petrograd Soviet meeting in the Duma, February 1917, striking workers had gathered to form a Soviet. Soviet means a council of ministers in some same building in the Duma. Duma is the parliament of Russia is called Duma. This was the Petrograd Soviet. The next day, a delegation went to see the Tsar. We all know the Tsar Nicholas II of Romanov dynasty. Military commanders advised him to leave the post. He followed the same and abdicated on 2nd March. Soviet leaders and Duma leaders formed a provisional government to run the country. Russia's future would be decided by a constituent assembly elected on the basis of universal adult suffrage. As we all know, universal adult suffrage means everyone who attains the age of 18 have right to vote. This is for now scenarios, but not for that time. So Petrograd had led the February Revolution that brought down the monarchy in February 1970. So the February Revolution brought down the monarchy from Russia. Now see what happened after February Revolution. Army officials, landowners, and industrialists were influential in the provincial government. Means their post was influential. But the liberals and socialists worked toward an elected government. Means the liberal and socialists wanted a elected an elected government. So restriction on public meeting and associations were removed. As we all know earlier, the associations were called illegal in Russia. Soviets like the Petrograd Soviet were set up everywhere, though no common system of election was followed. In April 1970, as we all know, the Bolshevik leader Vladimir Lenin returned to Russia from his exile. He and his Bolshevik peoples opposed the war since 1914, as we all know that World War First started from 1914. Now he felt it was time for Soviet to take over power. So he declared the April Thesis. This is very important. The war In April thesis, we read, the war be brought to a close, land be transferred to the peasants who used to till them, hai na? Banks be nationalized. So these three demands were called Lenin's April thesis. He also argued that the Bolshevik party renamed itself the Communist Party to indicate its new radical aim. So he changed the name of his Bolshevik party into Communist Party to show his radical aim. The revolution of October 1917, as the conditioned conflict between the provincial government and the Bolshevik grew, Lenin feared the provincial government would set up a dictatorship. So in September, he began discussion for an uprising against the government. Bolshevik supporters in army, Soviet and factories were brought together. On 16 October 1970, Lenin persuaded the Petrograd Soviet and the Bolshevik party to agree to a socialist seizure of power. A military revolutionary committee was appointed by the Soviet under Leon Trotsky to organize the seizure. The date of the event was kept a secret. The uprising began on 24th October. Sensing trouble, Prime Minister Kerensky had left the city to summon troops. He see this incident as a time which is not good for the Russia. At dawn, military army men loyal to the government seized the building of two Bolshevik newspapers. Pro-government troops were sent to take over telephone and telegraph offices and protect the Winter Palace. Now these are some dates of the Russian Revolution. As we all know, the Russian followed the Julian calendar until 1st February 1980. The country then changed to the Gregorian calendar, which we used to follow nowadays in the current days, which is followed everywhere today. The Gregorian dates are 13 days ahead of the Julian calendar. So by our calendar, the February Revolution took place on 12th March and the October Revolution took place on 7th March. Now these are some important dates. 1850s to 1880s, debates over socialism in Russia. 1898, formation of the Russian Social Democratic Worker Parties. Earlier we know the parties or these groups are illegal in Russia. The 1905, the Bloody Sunday and the Revolution of 1905. 1917, 2nd March, abdication of the Tsar. The Tsar left the Russia. 24th October, Bolshevik uprising in Petrograd. 1918-20, the Civil War time. 1919, formation of Comintern. 1929, beginning of collectivization. Now, what changed after October? The Bolsheviks opposed private property. As we all know, they are believer of socialism. Most industries and banks were nationalized in November 1970, as we read earlier in Lenin's April thesis. Government took over ownership and management. Land was declared social property, and it is allowed to seize the land of the nobilities and given to the tiller who used to till the lands. In cities, Bolsheviks enforced the partition of large houses according to family requirement. So, as we all know, the properties were also pooled between Russian peasants according to their family. So, same happened here also. They banned the use of the old titles of the aristocracy to assert the change. New uniform was designed for the army and officials. The Bolshevik party was renamed the Russian Communist Party in November 1970. The Bolshevik conducted the election to the Constituent Assembly, but they failed to gain majority support. Means they at that time they are not popular, so they failed to gain majority. support. In January 1918, the assembly rejected Bolshevik measures and Lenin dismissed the assembly. He thought that All Russian Congress of Soviet was more democratic than an assembly elected in uncertain conditions. In March 1918, despite opposition by their political allies, the Bolsheviks made peace with Germany at Brest-Litovsk. Now the Civil War. When the Bolsheviks ordered land redistribution, the Russian army began to break up because mostly soldiers wished to go home. Non-Bolshevik socialists, liberals, and supporters of autocracy condemned the Bolshevik uprising. Their leader moved to South Russia and organized troops to fight the Bolsheviks, the Red. During 1918 and 1919, the Greens means the Socialist Revolutionary and Whites means pro-Tsarist controlled most of the Russian Empire. They were backed by French, American, British and Japanese troops. All those forces who were worried at the growth of socialism in Russia. As these troops and the Bolsheviks fought a civil war, looting, banditry and famine become common that days. Supporters of private property among whites took harsh steps with peasants who had seized land. By January 1920, the Bolsheviks controlled most of the former Russian Empire to cooperate with non-Russian nationalities and Muslim Zardist. As we all know, the Muslim Zardist means the reform community or the social reformers of Muslims. Now, making of social society. So, now we talk about the socialist society. During the Civil War, the Bolsheviks kept industries and banks nationalized. They permitted peasants to cultivate the land that has been socialized. Bolsheviks used confiscated land to demonstrate which collective work could be. A process of centralized planning was introduced. Officials assessed how the economy could work and set target for a 5-year period. On this basis, they made the 5-year plan. As we all know that nowadays in our country, we also use to follow the 5-year planning. The government fixed all prices to promote industrial growth during the first two plans. New were deported, forcibly moved from one's own country. Stalin and collectivization. As we all know, after the death of Lenin in 1924, the period of early planned economy was linked to the disaster of the collectivization of agriculture. This was introduced by Stalin, so that is why it is called the Stalin's collectivization also. By 1927 and 1928, the towns in Soviet Russia was facing an acute problem of grain supplies. The government fixed prices at which grain must be sold, but the peasants refused to sell their grains to government buyers of these prices. Stalin, who headed the party after the death of Lenin, introduced firm emergency measures. He believed that rich peasants and traders in countryside were hoarding stocks in the hope of higher prices. This had to be stopped and supplies confiscated. In 1928, party members toured the grain producing area, supervising enforced grain collections and raided kulaks. Kulaks means it is name for well-to-do farmers in Russia. As shortage continued, the decision was taken to collectivize farms. It was argued that grain shortage was partly due to the small size of holding. Because of small size, the modernized way of agriculture is not going to be practiced in the small farms. So after 1970, land has been given over to peasants. these small-sized peasants' farm could not be modernized. To develop modern farms and run them along industrial lines with machinery, it was necessary to eliminate kulaks. As we all know, that kulak means the well-to-do farmers and the big farmers also, we can say. Take away land from peasants and establish state-controlled large farms. What followed was Stalin's collectivization program. From 1929, the party forced all peasants to cultivate in collective farms, which is called kolkhoz. So, the big collective farms were known as kolkhoz in Russia. The bulk of land and implements were transferred to the ownership of collective farms. Peasants worked on the land and the kolkhoz profit was shared. Between 1929 and 1931, the number of cattle fell by one-third. Those who resisted collectivization were severely punished. Means everyone have to follow the system of collectivization. Who do not follow this, they have to be severely punished. Many were deported and exiled. Due to punishment, many of the people were deported and exiled from the country. Now let's see the global influence of the Russian Revolution and the USSR. In many countries, communist parties were formed, like the Communist Party of Great Britain. The Bolsheviks encouraged colonial people to follow this experiment. By the time of the outbreak of the Second World War, the Russia means the USSR has given socialism a global face and world status. In the world socialist movement too, it was recognized that all was not well in the Soviet Union. A backward country has become a great power. Its industries and agriculture had developed and the poor were being fed, but it has denied the essential freedom to its citizens and carried out its developmental program through repressive policies. By the end of the 20th century, the international reputation of the USSR as a socialist country had declined, though it was recognized that socialist ideals still enjoyed respect among its people. But in each country, the idea of socialism were rethought in a variety of different ways. So, thank you all of you. Thank you so much. Hope it is useful for you all.